How is everyone doing today? I am feeling good. I am much better than I was in my last video. I was so sick then, but I'm all better now. I know I've been on a little hiatus for the last 2 weeks, but life has been changing. I quit my old unfulfilling job and I started two new jobs that I'm so happy about. I already feel so much better, so much happier. But I've been training at both jobs, so I haven't had a lot of time in my hands, but now I'm finished training, I'm getting to the groove of things, so I'm back for video. So this is my Valentine's Day look. I'm probably gonna do a couple different Valentine's Day looks between now and then, just because I think it's kind of fun to play with it for the season. So this is what I came up with. I wasn't exactly sure what it was gonna be, but I absolutely love this. I had a little bit of idea. I knew I wanted to do the pink with the maroon and the cut crease with the glitter, but this turned out so much better than I thought it was going to. And I also did this Tarte pink liner. I was a little nervous about trying it with this look, but I love it. I think it looks so good. It's so Valentine's Day-y, so like fun and playful, and I would definitely wear this to go out. I mean, personally. The only thing about this video is I want to keep it a little bit shorter, so I'm just going to go really in depth into my eye, like the actual eyeshadow itself, and my full rest of my face, probably my eyebrows as well. Well, not. I did get a suggestion to do a more in-depth full face, like how I get my base, and more in-depth on eyebrows as well. If you guys want to see those, like this video and go ahead and write in the comments which one, or if you'd like to see both, or any other looks that you want to do. So I already have one eyebrow done, and I'm just going to do the other one on camera really quick, and I'm probably just going to speed through it really quick. Eyebrow brush, I don't know what brand it is because I got it in one of my Ipsy Glam bags, and it is the best thing that ever happened to my eyebrows. Before, I was using this Beach Cosmetics brush with the spoolie on the end, and I still use this. This is what I use to brush them out. But if you can just see, let me see if you can get them. But the two compared to each other. So the one is obviously a lot fluffier, this one. It's the same angle, but this one being so much skinnier, I can really get those lines. I feel like before my eyebrows always looked different and I could never get them consistent. And with this, I've actually been able to kind of keep my eyebrows consistent. Again, I can go more in depth into another video if you would like. So I'm just gonna speed through this one and then we'll keep going.
Walked into the room and now my heart's been stolen. You took me back in time to when I was unbroken. You're all I want, and I knew it from the very first moment. Cause the light came on when I heard that song. I want you to sing it again. I swear that every word you sing, you hold them for me. Like it was a private show. I know you never saw me. When the lights come on and I'm on my own,
so for this look, I really want clean lines, which I can use a makeup wipe to clean up afterwards. I'm gonna use tape. So I learned this trick. If you stick it down to you once and then pull it up, it's not so harsh when you're taking it off of your eyes. I wanna do some other Valentine's Day looks as well, just for fun. Maybe like a little challenge, do a couple before Valentine's Day. So you'll have options if you want to do any of them. This one I think is going to be more casual, but I can do some other pretty dramatic ones as well. Let's get started. So, to start out, I'm going to go into my Take Me Back to Brazil palette, which I love. These colors in here are so fun. Ooh! These colors are so fun. They're so bright, tropical-y, so fun. So fun. And they're very pigmented, which you don't always get with a cheaper eyeshadow palette. BH Cosmetics is amazing. I recommend it. I have their foundation. I've used their powders. I've used their concealers. I've used their brushes. This eyeshadow palette is one of my favorites from them. It is so much fun to play with. And I love colors. And I have another look in mind that I want to do that will probably mostly, solely be based out of this palette. And I can't wait to do that look for you guys. But this palette, highly recommend. I think it was like maybe $15 or less. You can't beat that. Look how many colors are on this thing. Let's see. 4 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's too much math for me, but that's a lot of colors. Anywho, we are gonna go and take this like winey red color, which let me see if I can. Yeah, no, I have no idea what the name of this color is, but red color, and I'm going to go in on my crease. So let's go. So I'm going to take this fluffy, kind of small brush. It's not a big fluffy one because I just want to really control it all in the crease. You walked into the room and now my heart is beating. And I want to go in, I'm not taking too much on my brush at a time because I don't want to do anything really harsh. I want to be able to slowly build it up and get that color that I want. You walked into the room and now my heart is beating. Should we leave, dream? Is it cool, is that all that? So I can already tell, now that I have some eyeshadow on, that this line is a little bit flatter. You can see that this one goes up more of an angle. So all that means, and it's not ruined, it'll be fine. And this is why, whenever I'm doing any type of dramatic eye look, I really like to do it before I do my foundation and everything, because if I already had my foundation on, I take these off, it is going to be a mess trying to clean that up because it's going to just ruin the base you have underneath. So when you do it first like this, you can go in afterwards once I take this off and I can, again, either with concealer or the wipe, just clean up that line just a slight little bit and make it go up a little bit more of an angle so that it matches this one. So I'm gonna go in with this smaller brush and I'm gonna go in with this dark purple here, and I don't really want to make this purple at all, but I want it to be a little bit more maroon than it's turning out right now. So I'm just putting a tiny little bit on my brush, and I even tapped it on the side because I don't want too much. I'm just trying to add color to it. I'm just going back in with that original maroon color to kind of blend it all out. Okay, so I'm going to go into my Subculture palette by ABH, and I'm going to take this color right here, which is a darker maroon color, and that is called All Star. So I'm going to take that, and I'm just going to go over. We're really layering with this first, like, base. All about that base. Anyways, I'm gonna take that and I'm actually gonna go back in with a fluffier brush and I'm just gonna go over again. It's not the color I want, so I'm just gonna make it happen. Yes, this is definitely more that like wine color that I wanted. Because who doesn't want wine on Valentine's Day? Come on now. Me and my dog will be sitting at home, probably with a bottle of wine and some chocolate and some treats for her. Maybe we'll watch some movies. Actually, my tradition the last 2 years has been to go to the Florida State Fair on Valentine's Day with someone very special to me who is no longer here. So I was thinking, I work in the morning on Valentine's Day, but I was thinking that I would go again this year by myself, and just honor her and that memory. And yeah, so I think honestly that might be what I do. But then I'll come home with a bottle of wine and cuddle with my dog and probably cry with her, but that's okay. That is what she's there for. She loves me no matter how much I cry. Also, if you live in Florida and you can ever get to the Florida State Fair, you should go. It's so much fun. And the food is always so good. This year, if I go, the last 2 years I've said that there's this burger that I want to try, and I have not tried it, but it's a burger with cheese and bacon and whatever on it. But then the bun, instead of just being a normal old plain bun, it's glazed donuts. I might get diabetes from it, I might get a heart attack from it, but I have to try it this year because I've been dying to for the last 2 years. And last year they got the steak sundae, which was fries with cheese all over it with pieces of steak and bacon sprinkled on top. You wouldn't think steak from a fair would be like so good. It was so good. It was so tender, so flavorful. Ugh. If they have it again this year, I'm gonna get it. I'm going to the fair basically for the food. I won't ride any rides alone. But the food, ugh, so good. So good. I can't wait. Can't wait. Cannot wait. And there's no better way to honor her than to go eat because she would have loved that. Okay, now I'm going back and okay, so I'm gonna go into another one of my BH Cosmetics. I'm gonna go into this. This thing is huge. Huge. Okay, so this is a BH Cosmetics eyeshadow palette. This thing, this bad boy, has 120 colors in it. 120 in one palette, and I think this was less than $20. How can you pass up on that? This thing is amazing. So look, and I dropped it, so I've lost a couple over here. But look at that, that's one. Then you just do that. Oh no, it looks like I broke one. But look, boom, more colors. I definitely did. Oh my god, how am I losing all of these colors? This thing literally stays in my makeup area. I don't take them anywhere. I don't travel with it, nothing. So, those is because I dropped it. These ones, I don't know. Anyways. I'm going to go in to this front sheet of colors. And I'm just going to take this small but slightly fluffy. And I've already put some on my brush. I'm just going to take this very light pink right here. I don't even really want you to notice it. And I'm going to boom, tap off any excess. Oh, I just smashed my finger in that. And I'm just going to go over this line right here and try to blend it out. So now that I have that, I'm going to go in and actually cut my crease. So for that, you want to use a very, very, very small brush. So this is my e.l.f. concealer brush, and you can see it's teeny tiny. It's super skinny. Perfect for cutting the crease. Go back to my Tarte Shape Tape, and again, I am the shade Fair. Don't be too concerned about your lines being so perfect when you're doing this, because we're going to be adding some glitter a little bit later. One, so your line doesn't need to be so perfect. Two, when you're going in to pack in whatever shade you are on your cut crease, that's going to help clean up your lines a little bit too. So you don't want them too jagged, but they don't need to be exactly perfect when you're doing this part. still look a little crazy. It's okay. Now I'm gonna go in with something to pack my eyelid. So I'm gonna go in with this Jaclyn Hill 42 brush. So it's just a tiny little flat brush. I'm gonna go back into my Take Me Back to Brazil palette. And I'm gonna take this very light pink color and I'm gonna pack that all over where I just cut the crease. And I'm gonna pat this everywhere on my eyelid, but when I get close to that line between the two colors, I'm gonna slightly just wiggle it back and forth just to kind of clean up those lines a little bit. Okay, now back into this. I want just a little bit more pink, so I'm gonna go with the shade right underneath that's just a little bit more pink. Lash XO eyelash adhesive. This is my eyelash glue I got off Amazon. I'm gonna go over where the two colors meet, just that line, and then I'm going to follow up with some red glitter to separate the two. The glue sometimes dries too fast, so we'll see how it works. Then I'm getting this glue all over my eyelashes. That is gonna make it so much fun when I try to put mascara or eyelashes on. So I have the glitter along the crease. Now I'm going to go in with this Tarte eyeliner in the shade Bubblegum. I have used this liner before. It's not the most pigmented, so I'm gonna spray a little bit of my MAC Fix Plus on the end of this angled eyeliner brush. I know it still looks so crazy, I promise, in the end, it's not gonna look bad. Well, it might look bad, honestly, I have no idea. But we're going with it. You took me back in time to when I was broken. We're going to take this off, and I always wanna peel from this side into your nose. So from your ear to your nose. Ear to nose. And also you wanna pull up. You don't wanna rip it down so much. Yay! Okay, I really like the way this is looking so far. Crazy. I'm gonna go do my face really quick and I'll be back. Ta-da! Okay, obviously I'm not done. I just wanted to go in and do my under eye now that I have my foundation, concealer, no bronzer, no contour, or anything like that yet. I'm gonna go back into my Take Me Back to Brazil palette here. And I am going to mix in this for my under eye. Tap off the excess. Now I'm gonna go in with that more pink shade that I packed on the second time. I'm just gonna blend that onto my lower lash line as well. Sorry, there's a hair stuck to it. So So that is it for the eyeshadow portion of my eyes. What I'm gonna do is go finish the rest of it and then come back to show you the finished product. Don't know why I keep making that noise, but yeah. So I'm gonna go do my contour, bronzer, blush, highlight. So I'm gonna go do the rest of that and then we'll see what it looks like when it's complete. Alrighty. So here we are, fully finished. Lipstick, lashes, everything. This is what we look like. Now I am ready for a Valentine's date. At home with my dog. If you liked it, please, please, please give it a thumbs up and comment down below. Subscribe as well. Always subscribe. And I can do more fun looks for you guys to see. Like I said earlier, I was just focusing on the eye look for this, so that's why I didn't go into when I was doing my foundation and everything. But if you guys really want to see stuff like that, go ahead and let me know. Like I said, I was thinking about doing an in-depth for the base of my makeup, so I probably won't do an eye look that time. I'll just go through with what foundation, how I do everything, the steps I take step by step, and go really in-depth into that. Or I can do an eyebrow tutorial where I just show you know, how I do my eyebrows, how I do them. And I also go back and forth. In these videos, I tend to use my dip brow, but I also sometimes just use a pencil and do my eyebrows that way. So whatever you guys want to see, I can do one dip brow, one pencil, whatever you guys want. So just let me know. Comment, like, subscribe. Thank you. I love you guys.